So do you guys remember what we talked about last week? Last week we talked about when we have a problem and the first step that we need to do. And the first step was what? Oh, Toby knows. Do you guys know what it was? That's right. The first step was to make sure that we are calm and we are not upset and that we take deep belly breaths. That is the first step is when we have a problem, is to make sure we are calm and ready to think. Because our next two steps that we need to do involves using our mind and self-talk. Now, do we remember self-talk? Self-talk is whenever we talk to ourselves and we are able to calm ourselves down and to think about what we need to do next. So when we have a problem like this little girl, she is trying to problem solve and she's doing a really good job because you can tell she is thinking about it, she is calm, and she is using self-talk. So when we use self-talk, it helps us to be able to work through our problem and to come up with a solution, because every problem has a solution and you can do it. So remember to stay calm and think about it and you use self-talk and you will find a solution. Have a good day.
You probably know that it's important to eat fruit and vegetables. But do you know why? Fruit and vegetables contain some very important nutrients that our bodies need. These include vitamins, minerals, and fiber. Do you know what vitamins and minerals are? Vitamins and minerals help our bodies to work properly. We only need them in small amounts, but we do need lots of different ones. The very best way to make sure we get all the nutrients we need is to eat a wide variety of different foods. All of the healthy food that we eat contains vitamins and minerals. To get enough of all the vitamins and minerals our bodies need, it's very important to eat a variety of fruit and vegetables. And vitamins do some very important jobs indeed. Vitamin A, found in orange fruit and vegetables, such as apricots and carrots, and dark leafy vegetables, such as savoy cabbage, helps to keep our vision healthy. Vitamin B1 helps our bodies release energy from food so that we don't feel tired. Lots of fruit and vegetables contain vitamin B1, including peas, spinach, and mushrooms. Vitamin C, which is found in citrus fruits, such as oranges and lemons, as well as in strawberries, tomatoes, and broccoli, among others, is important for helping our bodies heal. For example, if we graze a knee. You can see that vitamins are really amazing. They protect us and make us strong. Fruit and vegetables are also a really important source of fiber. Fiber helps to keep our digestive system healthy. Do you know what is meant by your digestive system? Your digestive system allows your body to take in the nutrients from the food you eat, starting from your mouth, moving through your stomach, small intestine, and large intestine. Fiber helps this process work properly in order to keep our bodies working as they should. We should make sure to eat at least 5 portions of fruit and vegetables a day to get all of the nutrients our bodies need from them. A portion is the amount you can hold in your cupped hand. And a great tip is to try and eat as many different colours as possible so that we get lots of different vitamins and minerals. What are some of your favourite fruits and vegetables? See if you can think of fruit and vegetables to match every colour of the rainbow.
Good morning, students. Today's lesson for Get Ready to Run is Be Strong and Run Along. It's important when you're running or doing any kind of exercise or even just in your regular life to keep your muscles strong. That keeps our heart healthy, that makes our bones stronger. So it's important to do that. And you don't have to have any special weights or anything to make your muscles strong. All you need is your very own body. You can do things like circles with your arms, okay? Bigger circles with your arms. You can also exercise your legs by doing things like wall sits. That makes sure that your body weight is helping to strengthen your leg muscles. You can also do sit-ups on the floor or push-ups on the floor, or leg raises, or any number of things to exercise those muscles. So remember, you want to keep those muscles strong so you can be strong and run along.
Don't forget, our Get Ready to Run event is this Saturday, February 29th. All students who have registered for the Fun Run will need to arrive at the University of Southern Mississippi, the Gulf Park campus, on Saturday, February 29th by 8:30 a.m. Remember to eat a healthy breakfast and drink a glass of water the morning of the race. Wear comfortable running clothes and shoes with your race day t-shirt over your clothes and your number pinned to the front of your t-shirt. And remember to have fun and run strong.
You know what, guys? Miss Nicole and I would never be ugly to each other. But we just wanted to reenact some of the things that you may experience at recess or in the classroom or at home with your brother and sister even. But we want to tell you about what happened after that little incident that you just saw on the playground.
When Miss Sonia called the teacher would come over and probably make Miss Nicole apologize to Miss Sonia. And what do you think you would have said if I said I'm sorry? Just right off.
Well, sometimes it's automatic to where you just want to say, it's okay.
But is it really okay what they did?
No, no. It's not. And we want you to know that you don't have to say it's okay. We want you to be able to say, I forgive you, but I don't want anything like that to ever happen again. You know, we want you to be able to use your voice to express when things are not right for you.
You stand up for yourself. And you tell them exactly what bothers you. Miss Sonia could have told me, no, it's not okay that you did that to me, but I do forgive you and I don't want that to happen anymore. And that's okay for you to say that.
Absolutely, and we support you in that.
So, at recess, on the playground, and the classrooms, and even at home, make sure that when you're apologizing or when someone's apologizing to you, that you discuss the behavior and go through what happened so that they understand what they've done and that you won't be able to do that anymore.